DaVinci Resolve 17 isn't out yet, but if any of the past updates have showed us anything, we have a lot to look forward to. So in this video, we are going to be going over 11 DaVinci Resolve 17 must-haves, and a lot of these suggestions are from you. So let's get into it. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest DaVinci Resolve tutorials put out. Number one is Border Lund. He says, a library for all stock footage that you've ever downloaded. Exactly like the sound effect library. And this is a really cool one because we have the sound effect library where you can actually link a folder that has a ton of sound effects and you can actually have access to all of those sound effects. And then you can literally just drag it and drop it on your timeline. Honestly, this is an awesome idea. Like, I would love to see this feature in DaVinci Resolve 17. For number two, Mark D says, fully customizable windows in DaVinci Resolve, pretty much like it was in Premiere Pro. All right, a lot of you have actually said this and that you've really wanted these customizable windows, and I completely agree. It would be great to be able to expand and customize and save layouts. So I'm completely all right with that. I think that would be an incredible addition and really affect people's workflow in a positive way. So at number three, Dannington says that he wants a feature where if you make a cut in your dialogue audio, an amazing AI algorithm finds and assembles perfect room sound slash buzz track, which you can actually drag out from the cut point as long as you need. What he's saying is that he wants to be able to extend like the background noise that's like separate from my audio. Let's say, for example, you hear my computer going. What he wants is for a feature that actually analyzes that noise from the background and makes it possible so you can literally take a pause and you don't hear a break in your background noise. Now, of course, that's a super intricate system, and I have no clue what it would take to actually make that, but I think it would be an incredible feature. And speaking of an incredible feature, number four is a separate panel for video and audio converting. So you know how you have the fusion panel, the deliver panel, the edit panel, all of that stuff, like just a separate panel for converting audio and video. So like if you want to convert a QuickTime file to an MP4 file, you can literally do it by dragging it in there. It would automatically recognize the file format and give you the options to convert it over to whatever other file format you want. Then it would convert it over and save a converted version of the file next to the original file, and then also import that over to your media pool. This really would ultimately cut out the middleman and having DaVinci Resolve be like the powerhouse of just video production. You can edit, you can make VFX, you can convert your files over, you can do all of the stuff. I think that'd be super cool. So number five, Ryan Humphrey says, an entire 3D space revamp. So to summarize this, he says that it's not just like one thing, that it literally would just need like a ground up rewrite because there's just a whole host of things that are just not working or are behind industry standards. And he goes on to give a list of things that really Fusion is behind in, mainly that there's no global illumination, no ray tracing, stuff like that. So he's got a lot of good to say. I mean, you're talking about a whole like ground up rewrite here, and it's a big undertaking for Blackmagic design. Now they can do it, and I think that they probably will because they know that it is a little behind. And number six, Imad Noor Estate says, more efficient RAM usage. Like Fusion chews through RAM like it's no one's business. I have 48 gigs of RAM on my computer, and there have been times where I have completely just maxed out all of my RAM. I would overall just love to see better hardware optimization for this program. Moving on to number seven, the Xbox Vision says, I would love to be able to sync clips by audio on the timeline. Yes. That would also be really nice. I know Adobe Premiere Pro does that because, I mean, I used to use Adobe Premiere Pro all the time. I still have not gotten over that fact. Of course, I've found other ways to go about syncing clips, and they've actually made a new interface in 16.1, but I still think the superior way to go about syncing clips is to literally highlight it, right click, go to sync all audio, and I think it'd be so easy like that. So yeah, I really want that to be a thing. Number eight, the Paranoid Factoid, he says to fix the keyframe editor. So quite honestly, the keyframe editor completely sucks in my mind. I hate using it. I love the spline tab. I love it, it's so great, but the keyframe editor is a freaking cancer. Every time I have to use it, I get frustrated. It doesn't do what I want it to do. I think that there could be some improvements. So I really do think the way that Blackmagic should go about this is by creating like a separate panel that pops down just kind of like the spline tab and allowing us to edit all the keyframes like that. Because currently clicking on the little diamond button and seeing your keyframe pop up in like a dinky little window, then moving it around and hoping you could get a curve out of it, it's so hard to freaking see. So number 9 is audio inside of the fusion tab. Like if I don't want to hear my audio, I want to be able to mute it. I don't want it just to be permanently muted. I want to have that option, because currently what you have to do is switch between the edit tab and the fusion tab if you want to sync up your words to like text popping up. And quite honestly, that is freaking annoying. I really think having a button that you can toggle on and off the audio would literally just change my life. So at number 10, a pause button in the rendering tab would be incredible. The fact that you can only start and cancel your render is kind of annoying, because there's sometimes where I wanted to pause my render, but I couldn't. It'd be so much easier to just pause the render, do whatever you had to do on your computer or in the program, and then start it back up. So finally at number 11, we have Luke Skywalker 1973, and he says a feature that would automatically cut at the rhythm of your music. Now that would be awesome. And what would be even better is if instead of making cuts, you also had the option to add markers instead of the cuts. So really this feature would improve the accuracy of like syncing up your rhythm to your B-roll. It would just make it so much smoother, so much easier, and save you a lot of time. So there you have it. There is 11 must-have features for DaVinci Resolve 17. If you have some other awesome feature ideas, put them in the comments below and let me know what you think about some of these I've said. So if you like this video, hit the like button. If you like me, hit the subscribe button. And if you really like me, hit the bell notification. You have no idea how much that actually helps. And as usual, the video on the top is all about 5 awesome, easy, and simple text effects you can make in DaVinci Resolve. And the video on the bottom is a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. But until the next one, peace.